I made a first-person zombie survival game in 3 days because I'm an antisocial bum with no life. You may think, hey, that's pretty cool, I bet the game has nice graphics and a rich storyline. Well, you know, it's up there, rubbing shoulders with the likes of God of War Ragnarok.
What the fuck is this piece of shit?
But how did I come up with such a revolutionary game idea and execute it so well? The plan at first was to create a first-person shooter that is set in space where your goal as a sentient android is to kill as many humans as possible. But then I continued watching The Walking Dead Season 3 and decided, fuck it, zombies it is. But I'm too lazy to write a story, which is why I settled for a score-based system where the objective of the game is to kill as many zombies as possible to achieve a high score. So on day one I created the player. This meant that I had to create the shooting mechanic as well as health and stamina bars. I'm too stupid to reinvent the wheel, so I just used a simple FPS asset from the Unity Asset Store. It came with a first-person controller, a shooting mechanic, a weapon inventory, and even sound effects.
Freaking zombies!
What? I know, my laptop is absolute dog shit. Once I have the money, I'm gonna get a better PC, of course. I modified the scripts and got rid of these goofy-ass sound effects, and voila, we have a fully functional first-person player. Except that he was immortal, and so I used my last two brain cells to create very mid-looking health and stamina bars. Then I was too tired to continue and play PokeMMO for 2 hours before I went to bed. On day two, I created the enemy. This meant that I had to make a zombie that constantly moves towards you and that can deal as well as take damage. I grabbed a basic zombie model from the Unity Asset Store and placed it into my scene. Then I just had to make it move towards me. I had some problems with that, and so I followed a tutorial. And just like that, my zombies could move around the level. After typing on my keyboard and fixing some stuff, it was time for me to design a system that allows them to deal as well as take damage. I gave my zombie health and fixed rates at which we can deal damage to each other. Then I created a simple spawner script that spawns a zombie every 3 seconds. While everything was okay on paper, I was not so quick to realize that the dude had no animations assigned to it. I quickly opened up my animation window and created transitions for each of the animations that came with the zombie asset that I downloaded from the Unity Asset Store, after which I modified my code so that these animations would actually play. Now my zombie had running, attack, and death animations. It could also hurt the player and be killed by him. After downloading some zombie sounds, it was ready. Then I used my magic hands to create this cool red hue that gets denser the more damage we take. Next, I wanted to create items that the player could pick up, such as an ammo box and a health pack. I didn't want to do that today though, because I was tired and so I played PokeMMO for 3 hours. On day 3 I had to finish the game, and so I created items, main and pause menus, a game over screen, the scoring system, as well as the level in which all takes place. Now this might sound like a lot, and that's because it is. Good thing I don't socialize, which means I have all the time in the world. So let me speedrun how exactly I did it. First, I downloaded an item asset from the Unity Asset Store and typed some shit on my keyboard while we had working ammo and health packs. Let's just ignore the fact that I'm a smooth brain and that the math for my health pack almost screwed me because I also had to reduce the red hue by the amount we heal, and that wasn't as simple as it sounds. Actually, it was. I just have autism. Then I created very basic main and pause menus, a game over screen, as well as a scoreboard that would display our score as well as our high score. The scoring system was pretty simple. By using something called player press, we could store variables in between sessions. It means that the high score is saved even after you close the game. Then I created a very shitty level. I drew a rough map on a piece of paper and then downloaded an asset from the Unity Asset Store that contains buildings and such. I then created the level using those buildings. I placed my items as well as my enemy spawners and then polished my project by cleaning everything up and refactoring my code. Then I made a very basic game icon and proceeded to build the game. But wait, I still need a name. I asked ChatGPT for name ideas and got the Undead Horde. And for exactly 2 minutes and 34 seconds I wanted to go with that name. However, I got recommended a Walking Dead video that had the words Last Stand in the title. And so I settled for The Last Stand as my game's name. It's fitting because you will die no matter what. The question is, how many zombies can you kill before you do? Now that I had a name, I built the final version of my game. And it was done. I had a working first-person shooter in which you have to kill an endless amount of zombies in order to get the high score. At this point you may think, wow, this game is truly beautiful, so unique, so different, I can't wait to play it, I want to play it. If that's you, which it probably isn't, I have a pleasant surprise for you. I uploaded the full game on itch.io for free, the link for it can be found on the top of the description. So feel free to download this quadruple A game and enjoy it yourself. But Chen wishes, how come it took you so long to upload this video if you only took 3 days to create the game? Well, that's because I procrastinated, my friend. And I did that by playing PokeMMO for 5 hours straight and then taking a day off. But in the end I got my lazy ass to write the script for this video, so that's why it took so long. If you liked the video, then please let me know by liking and sharing it with your friends, assuming you have friends. And while you're at it, tap that subscribe button. My monkey brain is happy whenever it sees the numbers go up.
Running OBS in the Unity editor was too much for me. I am very tired. I will go to sleep now.